Hi dear friends, welcome back to Ryob Games. In this Unity tutorial, we're gonna make a level menu. Also, in this video, you will learn how to create a navigation buttons and a navigation bar, implement swipe detection, and add button click animations. Okay, let's get started. As you can see, currently there is only a background object on our scene. Let's start by adding a canvas to the scene. Right click on the hierarchy panel and create a canvas. I will make a small adjustment in the canvas settings. That's it. I will right click on the canvas and create an empty object called scroll view. And I will change the width and height over this object. And then right click on the scroll view object and create an empty object called level pages. I will create an image under the level pages object. And I'll call it page 1. Resize the page 1 object. Duplicate page 1. I wanna change the colors of the pages. Select the level pages object and add horizontal layout group component. Set the position of the level page like this. I'm gonna set the spacing to 100. I'm gonna add a content size filter component to the level pages. Start the game. As you can see, the level pages are currently not scrolling. I wanna be able to scroll the level pages in the game like this. So, select the scroll view object and add the scroll rect component. I will drag and drop the object I wanna scroll here. Then, we determine which area will detect the scrolling motion. Drag and drop the scroll view object to the slot. Start the game again. As you can see, we can scroll the level pages object as we want. But I only want it to move horizontally. So I'm gonna disable the vertical scroll feature. And I'm gonna disable the inertia feature. Now I'm gonna add the level buttons to the pages. Delete the text object of the button. And I will resize the button. Duplicate the button. I will use the grid layout group component to properly align the buttons. Select page 1 and add a grid layout group component. Start the game. I will rename the buttons. I wanna change images of the buttons. I created button images with Adobe XD before. I will drag and drop the images to the source image of the buttons. I will delete page 2 and page 3 and then duplicate page 1. I will rename the buttons of page 2. And change the button images of page 2. I will do the same process for page 3 as well. Select scroll view object and add mask component. To perform the masking operation, we need an image component. Start the game. Select all pages and remove the image component because we don't need it. Now I will add the page navigation buttons. Right click on the canvas and create a button. resize the button. I'm gonna change the image of the button. Set the position. Duplicate the button. And set the position. Change the image of the button. Start the game. I will assign the function of the navigation buttons. Before creating the swipe controller script, I would like to install the LeanTwin package. The LeanTwin package is a popular twinning library that provides a variety of functions for creating smooth and controls animations. It allows you to animate game objects, UI elements, and properties over time with ease. Click on the window and click on the asset store. Click on the search online button. Find the LeanTwin asset. Click on the Add to My Assets button. After that, open the Package Manager. Select My Assets. You can see LeanTwin here. I downloaded it already. You can first download it and then import it. The LeanTwin asset imported. Select the scroll view object and then add a script named swipe controller. Open the script. First, I will create the necessary variables that I need. I will create public functions named next and previous. And I've created a function named move page. If you would like, I can create a detailed video on how to use LeanTwin. You can access this script in the description. Okay, save the script and go back to Unity. We have three pages. Drag and drop the level pages object here. We can set the duration for transitioning to the next page using twin time. And set the twin type. Let's determine the page step. Select level pages. What should be the amount of position change to transition to the next page? In this example, a position change of minus 800 units on the x-axis is required to navigate to the next level page. This number may be different in your project. Let's add an event function to the navigate buttons. Drag and drop the scroll view object here because it has the swipe controller secret. Select the next function. Start the game and test it. As you can see, navigation buttons work properly. You can change the twin time as you want. And you can set the page step as you want. Let's take a look at the twin types. You can find the best twin time and twin type for you by trying. Let's add the swipe detection feature. Open the swipe controller script, add event system library, and I will add the end drag handler interface. Implement the interface. I will create a variable named drag threshold and set the variable. If we swipe the page more than the drag threshold value, the page will change. Save and go back to Unity. Start the game. As you can see, when we scroll more than the value we set, it moves to the next page. Okay, swipe detection system is ready. Let's add the navigation bar. Right click on the canvas and create an empty object named level bar. Right click on the level bar and create an image. drag and drop the bar closed image to the source image of the bar. Duplicate the object. Select level bar object and add horizontal layout group component. I will replace the image of the active pages bar with the open bar. Open the swipe controller script. First, I will add the UI library. Then create an array to keep the image components of the bars. Then create a sprite variable named bar close and bar open. I'm gonna create a function named update bar. I will set all bar images to bar close with a for each loop. After that, I will change the bar image of the current page to bar open. I will call the update bar function from awake and the move page function. Go back to Unity. Set the bar image array size. And drag and drop the navigation bars here. Drag and drop the images to the slots. Let's test it. Nice, navigation bar works properly. When on the first page, I wanna disable the interactable feature of the previous button. And when on the last page, I wanna disable the interactable feature of the next button. I will create a button variable to keep navigation buttons. I'm gonna create a function named update arrow button. That's it. I'm gonna call the function from awake function and move page function. Save and go back to Unity. Drag and drop the navigation buttons to the slots. Start the game. As you can see, on the first page, the previous button's interactable feature is disabled. And on the last page, the next button's interactable feature is disabled. You can add button click animation using the LeanTune library. I'm gonna create a new script named button animation. I will add this script to all buttons, and when the button is clicked, the anim function will be called. Save the script and go back to Unity. Select the button to which you wanna add animation, and add the button animation script. Start the game. Looks cool. I hope the video was helpful to you. Please don't forget to hit the like button. Thanks for watching and see you in the next Unity tutorial.